All right, good morning, guys. Saturday morning, we're out here at the show in Phoenix. We did make it to the show. You see the truck here behind me? And man, what a showing it is. There is a ton of trucks here. I'm gonna get as much footage as I can and try to meet some of these guys. The coolest part about coming to a show, especially a show like this, is you get to meet the trucking world that still has a lot of pride in what they do. To me, I don't care what you drive. If you'll spend the time to shine on your truck, then you've got what it takes, you know, and that's something that is almost lost in the industry today. And so that's why I enjoy coming to these shows. I enjoy showing off what we build. I enjoy, more than anything, meeting the people, the other guys, talking to them, seeing what they build, seeing the trucks that they take all their extra time to polish and put lights on. And in all reality, there's just a bunch of good people here. You meet the old school guys, you meet the new guys, you meet everybody. And just a lot of fun. And today's gonna be a lot of fun. And it's gonna be a great show. But I'll get some video, but I've got a special guest here that I wanna introduce you to here. All right, guys, this is probably one of my favorite things. We've got Marvin here. This is the Marvin Rainer. Marvin is the guy that I bought this brown truck from. How long did you own the truck, Marvin?
Since 1984.
1984, you had the truck in 84. Where did you find it?
I bought it out of a pasture in San Antone, Texas.
San Antone.
New Brunswick.
And you had seen the truck for a little while.
Yeah.
You were running back and forth, you said?
Back and forth to Houston. And I seen it sitting out in the field, and it just kept sitting there and sitting there and sitting there. And so finally I stopped in one day and, "You want to sell it?" He says, "Well, I don't know. I think I might want to sell it. I hadn't used it. I bought it and it's never been used." So I said, "Okay, what do you want for it?"
And
I went home and got the money and brought it back and bought it.
Bought it. And so you've had it for all that time. You worked it, you drove it yourself, you had drivers in it. What? How did you run it?
Well, I had a driver on it for about 9 years when it had the K in it.
Yeah.
And then he got killed in a car accident, so I parked it, and then I put another driver on it, and he made two trips on it, tore the fender off on the scales in Roswell, New Mexico. Somebody got that concrete pylon on the scales in between the tire and the fender, tore the tie rod out from under. I got a new tie rod. Me and my cousin went down there and put it on. Patched it up as good as we could. I drove back to the house, parked it.
And so you had that one driver in about 9 years. Outside of that, that's probably most of the trucking it's done its whole life, huh?
Just when I drove it.
And other than when you drove it.
It never run again.
And then, and until I've talked you out of parting ways with it.
You did talk me out of it.
Yeah. So that is awesome. What are your thoughts on what we did to the truck? How do you feel about it?
I'm loving it. I'm not going to tell you anything that needs to be done to it because I've already told you.
Marvin keeps telling me.
And I'm proud of it.
Well, that makes me really happy. Marvin keeps telling me you're one paint job away. And I know there's a lot of people that want us to really paint the truck. I don't know why. I'm just a sucker for an old ratty paint. I like an old ratty paint with a clean frame and everything, and I don't know. Maybe someday we'll get tired of it and we'll throw a paint job on it. But.
Well, you know what would look good then? One of your workers told me this. If I brought that Aerodyne, I've got one just like it.
Yeah. So Marvin's got a 81. It's an 80 extended hood Aerodyne with a B model cat. He's been working on it. It's a beautiful truck. What's the wheelbase on it? Like 280? 280. It's got that 8-bag air ride still. Well, you put 8-bag back on it after the stretch. But yeah, it's a beautiful truck too. So
I'm looking for a home for it. Anybody interested in it?
A good home, he says. It,
yeah.
And honestly, I buy a lot of trucks from guys. And for me personally, I like a truck that has personality. It has a history. Buying this truck from you was perfect for that because the history that you had with the truck. And the trucks I've bought in the past from guys that were kind of similar stories, it brings a new sense of pride to the truck seeing it go to a good home. Would you agree with that?
I'm all for it. That's why I sold it to you.
Yeah. You don't want it to go just anywhere.
No, I don't want it to go anywhere. I pretty well investigate the people. I knew that you were that kind of person when I met you.
Yeah.
I know it instantly that you're that kind of person. And so I let the truck go and...
Been pleased.
Yeah, it was hard.
Yeah.
It was hard.
Sure. Well, the thing with these old trucks is... Especially a truck that you've owned that long, not only is it a truck that you enjoy, but it helped provide you a living for many a years. And so things like that kind of become a part of the family, right? And
well, it was like I told you, it was these two trucks are one of my prized possessions.
Yeah.
If they don't go to the right place, I'll let them go.
Yeah, no. Well, I can't say thank you enough. Marvin has been a good friend. You get the opportunity to let us take part of your history, you know, and I hope we make you proud. And unfortunately, when you sell a truck to somebody like me, you don't just sell the truck. You get stuck with me, too.
Yeah.
So, Marvin, I'll blow Marvin's phone up. Marvin won't hear the end of it. We're linked together through this truck, and that to me is cooler than anything. So,
well, I'm just so proud of what you've done to the truck, and to see it look like this after so many years, it's awesome. That's all I can say. It's just awesome.
Yeah. Well, we appreciate you. Thank you, guys. If you guys need to get a hold of Marvin, got any questions on that other truck, get a hold of me. And I can put you guys in contact. But just remember, he's not going to let it go just anywhere. Got to be the right place, right guy.
That's right.
Yeah, treat it right. So.
And it's almost done.
Yeah, it's further along than this one was. Yeah. Yours, that one will run and drive. Yeah, it's a good one.
Yeah, it's ready. It's working truck right now. It can work.
Yeah, it's a good one. So, all right. Well, thanks again, Marvin. Thanks for coming out. He came all the way out from El Paso. So. Just to come out and see the truck.
I wouldn't miss this for the world.
Wouldn't miss it for the world. Well, we can't thank you enough for coming out and giving us the opportunity to be a part of your history and the history of this truck and give it a second life, essentially. Yeah. So, pretty exciting. And the build was quick. Made it enjoyable to see it come together that fast.
I followed it all the way. In fact, I even had to text him for day 12, 13, and 14.
We
got behind.
Man, we got to putting in so many hours on this truck. I'm doing all the video editing myself as well. And man, we would work till 2-3 in the morning. And I would fall asleep with my phone in my hand trying to edit videos. So I got a couple days behind. I think we're about caught up now. But it was fun to see it all come together that fast. So anyway.
I love what you did with the brown interior. Took that old red carpet out.
Yeah. Every time I took something out, Marvin said, I remember putting that in there.
Yeah.
Well, thanks again, Marvin, and we appreciate you.
Well, I'll be here the rest of the day.
Good deal. Awesome.
I'm not going back till tonight.
Yeah. Well, that to me right there is probably one of my favorite parts of the whole gig is getting to know guys like Marvin that have been doing this stuff forever, and it is actually really fun to see them get excited about something that they cared about for so long and put it back out on the road. So super exciting, way fun to be a part of. Super grateful that Marvin come out and spend the time seeing the truck today. All right, guys, this truck show has turned out to be really, really cool. A lot of good stuff, a lot of cool trucks. I'm going to show you some more of them, but you guys have all seen my white 77 that we just built the end of last year. Today I've got two of my favorite people. You got to meet Marvin and the brown truck earlier. This is Donna and Brad Cunningham. Brad, you're not going to break the camera. Get in here. All right. Brad and Donna is who I bought this truck from. When did I buy it? The end of last year, right?
Yes.
Last fall. And I've seen Brad run this truck for a long time. How long did you own the truck, Brad?
About 29 years, 30 years.
30 years. Brad owned this truck, and I remember for a long time seeing this truck. He was a local guy, local truck, and that narrow nose always stood out to me. And when I'd see Brad, I'd catch him at the mine or wherever at the scales, I'd say, Brad, you gotta sell me that truck. He was pretty stubborn about it. He didn't want to let it go, did he?
Nope.
Well, that, you know, these trucks, they become a part of the family whenever you've been, I mean, it earned a living for your family for forever, right?
30 years.
For 30 years. And anything like that, it essentially becomes part of the family. And so it was tough doing. I don't remember how it all worked out, but Brad finally agreed to let it go to me, which was awesome.
Because we knew you would take care of it.
Because you know how to take care of it. Well, we've done our best, and what do you guys think of what we've done with the truck?
I think it's
super fantastic.
Couldn't have done better. You like it? Make you guys proud?
I love it.
Yep.
I love it.
That is awesome. Honestly, I just love a truck with history and good people. And you guys are about as good as any I've ever met. And
Feeling is mutual.
Well, appreciate you guys. And I can't thank you guys enough. We have loved building this truck. It's fun to watch it come back to life again. We get to bring it out to places like this. There are people that come out and appreciate the truck all over again. And it's created a whole nother life for itself, you know, again. You know, after 30 years, it gets a second life, you know, and a whole new appreciation. People that also appreciate it, probably not quite as much as you guys or myself, but close. Pretty close. So yeah, no, super fun.
Even though you have it, it's still our old baby.
It'll always be your guys' baby, huh? You know, every truck needs a good name. And when I build trucks, we just start naming them after the people we bought them from. So we just call this truck Brad. That's what we always call it. Or we call it Brad or the Brad truck, but it will forever be Brad.
All right.
Forever be Brad. And we've done a ton of work to it. And you guys have been so dang good to me and my crew. And we just can't thank you guys enough. And it's been a lot of fun to be a part of the whole history with it. And to know the history. So, thank you guys.
Thank you.
Yeah, appreciate you guys. That's Brad and Donna. We've had them part of this whole build from day one, and it's been sure fun. Brad gets a little camera shy, but man, this has been one of the funnest trucks. It was a fun truck to build. It's a great truck to enjoy to drive, even to this day. So, and I still run it quite a bit. We got my equipment trailer, we hooked to it, and just sure makes it fun.
I enjoy looking at the pictures.
Yeah, it brings a whole different kind of happiness, huh?
Yes, it does.
Yeah. Awesome.
I got one question to ask you now.
What's that?
Does your dad drive it?
Dad has drove it. He doesn't drive it a lot, but he has drove it. Every time my dad drives it, he says, that is not an old A model. He said, that thing drives so good. He loves it. So.
Well, my feeling's mutual with him.
Yeah, he is.
I'm just glad we can still see it and know that you're taking it.
Yeah, no, for sure. And Brad and Donna, they live 5 minutes from me. And we get busy, but I still drive it out to their yard every once in a while. And kind of like Santa Claus and the reindeer showing up at the little kid's house. They all come out, and yeah, super fun.
So
yeah, it's like Christmas. So super fun. Thanks again, Donna. Appreciate you.
Appreciate you.
I'm from outer space. I got Milky Way for blood, evolution in my veins. I'm gone. I've been far away. I'm a loomer in. I'll make a moon, start of waves. I've been dreaming about flying for a long time. I had a vision from the first day on the coastline. Artificially intelligent to AI. I'm your future, past and present. I'm a fine line. Yeah, I'm a miscellane of this illusion. I am not really here. I'm an intrusion. I don't swim or sink. I just flow. I don't need gravity. I just need more. When I move, is it a quick rumble? I won't ever, ever fall, ever stumble.
He's these guys came all the way out here from El Paso just to come out and hang out with the old Iron Crew and check out the truck. Dude, it literally doesn't get any better than that. These guys are cool as heck, working on trucks, building their own trucks. Oscar, what is your truck you're building?
It's a 75W9.
And watching our stuff help you, inspire you to keep going, what is it?
That's where my inspiration comes from.
That right there is exactly why we do exactly what we do. It doesn't get any better than that, and that's why we do it. It brings a smile to my face. I think it's too cool. Thanks, guys. Thanks for coming out, dude. Appreciate you guys. It's awesome.
All the pretty girls walk like this. In the beat, flooded out my wrist with some ice around my neck. Water, no, my ass, on to the neck. Okay. He know this good, cause he always come back. I'm like, damn, fly me to a island. If I say I want it, then you know he gon' drop. Money, foreign, class, designer, style. I'll throw a tear to know a bitch to get chowed. Go down on the deep, know he loving the move. Okay. If I'm f***ing with him, he f***ing with you. Make him blow a pass, with it all on shoes.
Good time this weekend out at the NHDRA Diesel Drags. We had a blast. We're packing up and leaving now, and now that everybody's gone, we get to get the real diesel trucks out here doing some dragging. We've got bracket racing going on here. Right here behind me, race number two, we've got the T&M trucking trucks. Got Jordan in his 359 with a load of hay on in the right lane, and in the left lane his dad Todd with a load of pavers on. This is going to be a race of the century. All right, father-son combo getting after it. All right. Today we've got another father-son combo here. We've got Travis in the white narrow nose with a big cam 400 ready to get after it. I'll be running the B model extended hood A, and we're ready to burn some rubber.